Heart Matters. Heart Matters.
Welcome back to the show. I hope you're enjoying the show. Today's topic is, when is the right time to date and who is the right person to date? Our hashtag is My Type. You can be part of the show through our social media handles that I am displaying at the bottom of your screen. It is Facebook page is Heart Matters. Our Twitter handle is heartmatters_matters. Now, before we went on break, we wanted to interrogate a little bit further if family members or your significant father or your significant other doesn't actually like the person that you're dating. Maybe Anne, you can start.
Sure.
Yes.
I think it's very important to consider other people's opinion, most importantly your parents or even your sister or your brother. However, you may realize that there are some people who have some reservations about a particular tribe, a particular hairstyle that may not really be of much importance in a relationship. Therefore, personally, I think I would really look unto the weight of the issue at hand, that they may not be liking the person I'm interested in. If it's something we can negotiate, I would go ahead and talk with my parents or significant others about that issue. Again, you should also try to listen to your intuition. Very important. Mm-hmm. Is what your parents are telling you in alignment with what you're feeling? Then I don't think if you are leading from the same script, there's need for going on with that relationship. But if it's something that you can tell your partner, oh, my mom doesn't like your mohawk, then that girl or the particular person can do away with the mohawk. That's something that you can get a remedy for. Thank you.
Mr. Choki, we've actually had cases where girls have presented their boyfriends or fiancés to their parents, and their parents have refused to accept that person to a point that that wedding actually happens without the parents in the wedding. How does that even get to that level?
I think I'm a parent, and now I'm beginning to understand. I never used to understand this, but now I'm beginning to understand. Parents have a particular, you talked about type.
Yes.
Type of person they want for their child. And then when the right time comes and the child comes with somebody who doesn't meet that type, there's that resistance. And I think that's what normally happens. Probably, as she's saying, he has a mohawk, he has rastas, and the parents have never imagined that their daughter will bring this kind of a man in the house. And so there's that resistance, or different tribe. But I do appreciate what Anna said. It's important to weigh what are they saying. Is it a red flag they are raising? And it's just good to listen to them. Don't dismiss them, that they are old-fashioned or they don't understand the dating or they don't understand what's happening. Don't just dismiss them. Hear them first. And then interrogate yourself within your heart and take time to find out. And even discuss maybe with a close friend and try to see, is what they are saying really making sense? Now, if it's not making sense in terms, many times it comes to tribe, because she's Kikuyu. Don't marry her. But nothing else apart from that. Okay, what? This is an individual. It's not a tribe I'm marrying. I'm marrying an individual. And so there have been those cases where people have gone ahead and gotten married. And I tell young people, don't worry. Don't be so worried. When you get the first child and name it after your parents, they'll be the first ones to come and celebrate.
Charles, should even the parent decide who you're dating? Should your parent actually decide who you're dating? What type are they looking for in your girlfriend?
Thank you. I think, according to me, the parents have a say to some extent, and I have my say. because it depends on the family values that you hold, because families have some ideals that circulate within that family or values that they hold as their own, and you may share in that. So if my family says that, or we don't believe in ladies who wear trousers, or ladies who dress in mini skirts. Mm. Yeah, those ones, if they we believe that, I will not go for that. Mm. But when I see that they are talking of this person from a very far place from where we stay, as long as we have accepted each other, I don't see they will agree. Mm. So for me, I will look at what do we hold together as a family so that I allow my parents to decide. Then if it is something else that I don't consider so valuable, then I will go and get that lady.
I'll come back to this issue. I think it's an important issue, because when we grow up from age 18, according to the person who said you have to be legally adult to start dating. Up to the time you decide to get married, there's a lot of choices on the way, and there are a lot of decisions that you have to make along the way. I want to go back just a little, because I'm interested to hear from our youth what they prefer as their best type of a man or a woman to date. Yes, the lady here. Let me start with you. Are you dating?
Yes.
You're dating. What year are you?
Third
year?
Yes.
Okay, is this your first date?
More or less, yes.
Thank you. So what's your type?
Okay. Mm-hmm. Let me start with the physical features first.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
So I'm a light skin, so probably go for something another that compliments skin. Me. I'll take someone who's dark, tall, dark, and handsome, you know. Mm. And after that, maybe I'd look into the mental aspects, or should I say someone who reasons in, let's say, not exactly in my thought of line, as per se, but someone who reasons as a humane person, who reasons as a person who is mature, you know? Yeah, for it to be easy. And I'd also look for someone who is spiritual in some way, if I may say so. Because I believe that there's an existence of another superior being, so I definitely look for someone who believes like that too. After that, then I get to know the characteristics, or maybe the person himself, before I, you know, kind of conclude that, okay, this is my type.
Yes.
Yeah.
So he must share your religious beliefs.
Yes.
He must be darker than you, or like very light than you.
A few shades darker.
Must he be strong with muscles? Or just
of course.
Oh, now guys, you have it. Let me hear from a guy. What's your type? Yes.
Okay, my name is George.
Are you dating?
Yeah, I'm dating.
What year are you?
I'm a third year.
Ah. Yeah, you're blessed with five. Is this your first date?
No, I've had a couple.
Thank you. So what's your type?
Oh, my type is, I know what is responsible for feelings towards someone is the dopamine levels in someone's brain. So if the lady that I'm dating has higher dopamine levels than mine, which translates to her having more feelings towards me, I get a chance to take a shot to the lady. But if I realize I give too much of my feelings to her, I'll tend to back off.
Okay.
And another thing, that's a part, that's one of it.
The is other there
thing,
a scale to the feelings?
Scale.
Like kilos or liters that just determines how heavy and how light?
Actually, dopamine levels, I don't think it has a scale.
It does not have a scale.
Yeah, but once I see how the ladies, like how she behaves while I'm around her, and the fact that while she's around me, she does not pick some calls, or once we spend time together, she switches off her phone. That gives me hope that I'm the right guy for her, so that makes me.
Okay.
That makes me.
She may be switching off her phone because she doesn't want the other girl, boyfriend to call while you're there.
I'm happy because she's willing to take the risk.
Okay. Let me hear from another lady.
That's a nice one. That's a very unique perspective.
Yeah, she's willing to take the risk. Yes. A girl first, then another guy. There's a girl right here.
Yeah.
There are two mics.
For me, I think in this time and era.
Are you dating?
No.
Why?
I consider myself I'm in the healing process, so.
You're in the healing process.
Yeah.
You're coming out from another relationship.
Yes.
What year are you?
Fourth.
Fourth year. Okay, so what's your type? What went wrong with that alone? You didn't fit your type?
No, actually, we didn't have the same goals in life.
Okay.
Yeah.
Goals?
That's the problem. Mm-hmm. So, in this time and age, I think, first of all, he must be straight, first of all. Yeah, in this time and era, some people are not attracted to girls, others are attracted to men. And then I have to be attracted to him, and then he has to be mature and a person who can understand each other at a personal level, and he has to compliment me and at least be willing to take that extra mile for me. For me, because some people are so egocentric and so self-centered, they just want you to fit into their schedule but not them to yours.
The lady must be the main thing, guys. The ego must shift.
Yes, I'm dating.
What year are you?
I'm first year.
Oh, good. Wow. Hey, is she a student?
Yeah, she's a student.
How long have you known her?
Like for the last 3 months.
Okay. So what's your type?
Yes. My type, I think, is the lady who we have the same interest.
Interest?
Yeah. The one who respects me, the one who understands my weakness and my strengths. Yeah.
So do you think she's the right type?
Yeah, I think she's the right type.
In 3 weeks' time?
3 months.
Yes. 3 months.
Yeah.
Okay. He must have muscles.
Yes.
He must be straight.
Yes.
Yeah.
I think I like what I'm hearing. And like the first lady said, you see, obviously what attracts you to each other is the physical. We cannot bypass that. We cannot overrule that. And it's true. They say that before marriage, opposites attract. But after marriage, they attack. They attack. So we are attracted, and I do hear her. I mean, I'm tall, dark, and handsome, and I used to look for a lady who was short and brown. I got a lady who's brown, but not short. But that was what I was going for, a short brown lady, because I just attracted to that. So they definitely, the outside that you look at, there are things that they are mentioning is very difficult to know at a glance. But those are things that now a dating relationship helps you to establish. Whether there's a dopamine level higher, are they feeling for you? Do they understand you? That takes a while, because everybody, and that's the thing, downsides of dating, of a first time dating, because everybody puts their best foot forward initially. Mm-hmm. But with time, you cannot pretend for long. The natural you, the real you comes. In fact, they say it takes about 90 days for the real person to come out.
90 days.
90 days. There's somebody
it feels
call
like
it
the Constitution.
A 90-day test. So a 90-day test will definitely reveal certain things, and the inward things now begin to come out.
Yes. Mrs. Achoki, I hear a lot of muscles, I hear a lot of complexion, but I did hear from the guys. Mm-hmm. Do the looks matter to the girls?
Well, to some extent, it does matter. Because you want to be attracted to the person that you're getting married to. But some of those things, again, in a relationship, there's give and take. Mm. So you don't have to really say, this is what I want and this is what I must have. For me, I look at it as the heart of the person. Is it somebody who is loving? Is it somebody who is caring? Not that the looks will not matter, but is it somebody who really cares about you? Somebody that you can hang out with, somebody that you will rather not live without. So those are some of the things that you will be looking at. But of course, the looks matter to some extent. Because you don't want to be embarrassed. You're with your friends and you're saying, this is Ule. Ule, who is Ule?
All right, we hear a lot of saying that beauty is in the eyes of who?
The beholder.
The beholder or the beer holder. Mm. It doesn't matter. Mm. Well, we are coming to the end of the show. Today we have actually looked at the who is the right person to date and when is the right time to date. Mm-hmm. Now, for more information about today's show, please log on to our Facebook page, Heart Matters. You can also follow us on our Twitter handle, heartmatters_matters. And before we end, I just need some few short remarks from our guests about what we heard from our youths today, starting with Anne.
Thank you. I think as our topic has been about heart matters, I must say heart matters can really hurt. Mm-hmm. So you got to be very careful for a first date. Do a thorough examination and that assessment. Gather as much information as possible. Do not get yourself to be hurt. Mm. Thank you.
Mr. Achoki.
Yes, the heart is the most important part of a human body, physically, but also emotionally. And so we have to be very careful how we handle our relationships. When is the right time? That is for you to decide. When you feel you are ready for it, please don't hurt your heart in the process. But also, on the other hand, it's a heart matter. As we look at the who, the type, let's not just be fixed on the six-pack and the hairstyle.
Or the one-pack.
Or the one-pack. And for the guys, don't just look for the dashboard and the bonga points. There's more to the heart. The what really matters is the heart.
Sure. Please, Mrs. Achoki. Know who you are. Who are you as a person? Because if you do not know who you are, then how do you expect somebody else to know you? Then what do you want in life? What do you value? Don't date because you're under pressure, because your friends are doing it, so you want to put up a show. Date because you know you want this relationship to go to another level.
Charles.
Today's topic has been very nice. And my words are that as much as we would like to date, the first thing is to take off the mask, to be open. Because if we are not open, the chances are very high that we may end up in a relationship that does not satisfy simply because we do not allow ourselves to see what is happening and to choose well and to understand who is the best that we are looking for. Mm-hmm. So openness is an important step in this journey. Thank you.
There you have it. Peel off the mask. Now, the right time to date, you decide. The who, know yourself, peel back the mask, and you really get the right person to
Absolutely.
Date. But just before we end, did you know that according to a survey done by the timeout.com, 7% of the youth have dated their lecturers or their teachers? 1 in 5 have dated their friend's ex. 14% have dated their neighbors. 38% have dated someone who is in someone else's relationship, of which 41% of those were someone who's in someone else's marriage. And 17% have dated their best friends. There you have it. Until next time, I'm Priscilla Getonga on KUTV, and this is Heart Matters.